Okay, so beginning of March, and it's a new missing inspiration time. I've got gesso absolutely everywhere, so I'm just gonna open this. So the first step for mission inspiration is to add some tissue paper to the background, so we can do that. I've gessoed this twice, but we can't tell because it just is opaque, but there we go. So use this one. Okay. I don't want that. I'm just gonna turn it up a little bit. How much of the background I'm going to cover. Let's just give this a go. Ugh. There we go. I do need to get some more matte medium. Oh dear. Right. Let's go. Not sure I'm going to use any of the colour prompts this time. I'm just going to make it up as I go along. Don't know. I think we have seen an end to the snow. It's sort of melting now. We were supposed to be having some sort of ice rain that freezes as soon as it hits the ground, but I haven't seen any of that yet. And to be honest, as I say, the snow seems to be melting, so I don't think we're going to get that in this area. Shall see. Now, just make sure that it's all stuck down. Think we're all good on that. Let's get in that corner there. There we go. And now I'm going to let that dry and then we'll be back with some gesso. See you in a minute. Alright, so next step is to add gesso with a baby wipe, gesso or paint, and I put way too much gesso out here, but we'll see what happens. Now I'm gonna just wipe this on. Hoping that the house doesn't get too noisy. My stepsisters are coming over. because their pipes have burst because of all the cold weather, and they need to use a shower. There we go. So there might be sections of this video where I don't use the sound, just to warn you. Right, while that's drying a little bit, I might get it with a heat tool in a minute, but I might as well use the time. There you go. I'm going to mix up a little bit of pale blue with this gesso. Cerulean. And we'll mix that together for the next step, which is to make marks on the page. It's a nice vague one because it doesn't say use this to make marks, use that to make marks. I was going to use a toilet roll to make some circles, but actually I changed my mind and I'm going to use some good old bubble wrap. Now, do I need to dry that? I don't think I need to dry it, to be honest. Let's just get a little bit of paint on here, not too much. On here, particularly where you can see the image coming through the background, and try and obscure that a bit. That's better. Now you can at least tell what it is. Start gluing a base coat of paper down over them, those images, because they really do shine through that gesso. There we go. And I think that is enough for that one. And now let's have a look. Add gesso, make marks, add texture with paste or embossing powder. Yeah, so now I just need to dry this and I will be back with the stencil and some texture paste. That will just show you what I'm going to do with this excess paint as well. I've got these stickers. I'm just going to spread it on with the baby wipe. And I want it it's coming out nice and streaky and like that. There's one, and then we should have enough to do another set. And then whenever I get extra other colours of paint, if that makes sense, I can do some stenciling things on top of here, and these will make some really nice little bits to stick on my art journaling. And then the rest of the gesso and stuff, I will find a book or a piece of paper to smear that onto to use in another project. Waste not, one not. Okay. Should be just about dry enough now. And I'm going to put my palette knife's handle into the gesso. It's helpful. Lovely. Right. squirt out some of this acrylic mousse, which I bought from Lidl, and I love it. I bought it last year, and I've just been waiting for it to come back in again, and it came back in, I think it was in January, and I snapped up another box, even though I haven't finished this one, because they are great. You get them in 4 colours, white, blue, pink, and purple, which is like a pale lilac-y purple. They're all sort of pastel-y, and they are really good. I love them. Okay. So, let's get the texture on here. I'm hoping to tell a little bit of a story with this page. Sorted things, so hopefully you'll see that coming through. Gotta make sure I keep an eye on the camera because the battery's a little bit low now. Hoping it will last for this page. I think I've put too much text to paste out actually. Try and be gentle here because I don't want to squash all this lot. There we go. Maybe just a little bit more. There we go. Oops. I'm not sure if I should have used the white, but no, there's a lot of white on there anyway, so I think we're okay with the blue. Let's just give this stencil a quick wipe. It comes off quite easily with a baby wipe, this piece. It's actually Marta Lukowska. I never know how to pronounce any that put me onto that this paste stuff, so thank you to her. I love it. Add a focal image, right. That means we can work on this while that's drying. I'm gonna do a technique that card makers use called paper piecing. Let's use the glossy accents that I have. in a precision bottle just because it's nice and easy. If I can find it. Excuse my face. Gonna be a pain to find. So let me grab this and this and hope there's enough left in it. Okay, so what you do is you stamp the image onto different pieces of paper and then fussy cut it out. Oh, the battery's really low. It's flashing at me. I don't know how long I've got. So, yep, so I've cut it out on blue and green for the dress. There's a lot of blue there, so I think I'm going to use green so that she stands out. And the same with the shoes. That's her little glove. I've got to think what order I need to do this in so the shoes can go on. It's a good technique if you're not very good at stamping, because you can just use scraps of paper that doesn't matter if you ruin it. And just cut out the bits that stamp well. Like on this, she didn't come out great like here, but it doesn't matter because she's going to get covered there. I just need her to be a basic outline. That's a skin tone sort of thing. And then we want the dress. Get on straight. I'm going to use a wet glue that's got a bit of movement to it, so you can move it if you put it in the wrong place. And then her little mitten, which I was very worried about losing. It's so tiny. Okay. There it is. I thought I'd lost that. There we go. Get her hair down. I don't know if that's focusing on something. See if we can get this bit done. And then I will charge the camera up. She's got a little bit of a fringe here. Let's see if I can get this the right way. Yep. And it's kind of nice to do some stamping on some book text as well. That adds a bit of interesting texture. I like doing it with different pattern papers. It makes it a bit more interesting. fully charged, but I've got a bit of charge in there. We'll get on with this a little bit. So I'm just going to add some detail with my basket paint pen. I have changed my sheet under here. I got some wax paper today in the post. If you don't come from the UK, you won't know, but we don't really get wax paper here like you do in America and Australia and all that, what you call deli paper or anything like that. So I had to order this from eBay, and I've been waiting for it, and because of the weather, the postman hasn't been able to get down here, so yeah, you know when you're just waiting for something and it seems to take forever. Detail here. Yeah, I'm looking forward to experimenting with this deli paper. Might even try doing sort of fake jelly prints because I don't have a jelly plate. So we'll have to make do with what I do have, which is a non-stick craft mat, which I might play with. See if I can get to an effect. Like that. Yeah, this battery's not going to last much longer again. Right, I'm just going to get, actually I'm not going to glue her down yet, I want to put some paint down. Or do I? Should I just use, I've got a big white Posca paint pen, let's use that, this might be quicker. You might have noticed that I did add some white modelling paste dots as well. I decided I did want that. Okay. Got a full battery now. Let's try and finish this off. So, just gonna grab this and as you can tell whilst we've been gone, I have been playing around with some sprays and things. My drop paper's not as pretty as it was. There. Get that nice and stuck down. And the next thing, metallic or shimmer splatters or drips. Whoa. Pick that lot up in a bit. So I've got my cosmic shimmers. There we are. And just need to give that a quick dry, so I'll be back in a second. There we go. And now that's dry. Let's see if I can catch it. There, can you see that? Shimmer. Anyway, there we go. And then next step is to add a quote or phrase. And I've printed this out on my label maker. And I just need a little pair of scissors. Cut this up. Where I'm going to put it. Yeah, like that. Finish it down a little bit. It's going over a lot of texture. Change my mind, put that there. There we go. Kindness is like snow, it beautifies everything it covers. Right, and then the last step is to create a contrasting border or frame. And I have this tool from We Are Memory Keepers. And I'm just gonna go along. I can never get this straight. Very happy with that. That is my page for March. Very snowy start of the month, so I wanted to represent that in my piece, and I think that's what I've done. So I'm very, very happy. I like it very much. I hope you enjoyed watching. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.